Hey, it's Jacob. This week we made out with strangers, we found our long-lost twin, and we crushed things with a tank. We also found out that given the opportunity, a lot of people would leave Earth behind forever. Would you take a one-way trip to Mars?
No. Don't really want to go to Mars.
No.
Nope.
Yeah. Why?
It's not just Alex. More than 200,000 people have applied for that one-way ticket. We wanted to find out more.
Mars One is a civilian program dedicated to sending the first humans to colonize Mars, which in my opinion is terrifying, but there are thousands of people who want to do it. They're still about a decade away, but they're actively moving forward with the project.
They will be flying to Mars in a transit habitat with a lander attached to it.
But my first reaction was, I think like anyone who would be confronted with such an idea, this will never work. But now look and listen more closely. This is really something that can be achieved.
They started with an open application process and got almost 250,000 submissions. It really makes you wonder what kind of a person would be willing to leave everything to go and live on Mars.
I'm glad you asked. This type of guy. They've narrowed the field of applicants down to around 1,000.
My family, of course, when I told them they were a bit shocked, but they had kind of half-hearted, like, wish me the best of luck, you know?
Yeah.
Like, I want that to happen, but at the same time, I mostly don't.
Only 4 astronauts are gonna be trained for the initial trip, which means a lot of people aren't gonna get their chance, like this guy.
Honestly, it's probably for the best. Why on Earth would you want to go to Mars?
Why on Mars would you want to go to Earth?
Today, we are making our audition tapes to go to Mars.
There's a lot of bodily functions that will be happening, and I will find ways to leverage that into jokes that will make the entire crew laugh.
Why am I the best candidate for the trip?
Sorry, Redlink, no preferential treatment.
Don't you have somewhere to be?
No, I don't.
Okay. Go have fun on Mars. Goodbye.
I don't want to go alone!
So you've been selected to go to Mars, but you don't want to sound like a tourist. Well, guess what? You're in luck. Discovery put together 10 facts about the Red Planet to get you ready for your trip. And remember to bring a sweater because nighttime temps can get down to -200 degrees.
Now that you know what you're in for once you land, let's talk about the challenges of touching down. This team of NASA scientists explained the landing process for 2012's Curiosity rover, and it's got over 2 million views.
This big, huge parachute that we've got, it'll only slow us down to about 200 miles an hour. And that's not slow enough to land. So we have no choice, but we've got to cut it off and then come down in rockets.
When you get there, look for the rover. It's still cruising around.
One of the most interesting things about all these videos is to see how much love there still is for space exploration. Now that you're more familiar with the project and all of its ins and outs, now would you take that trip to Mars?
No!
No.
No! No one wants to go to Mars!
Yeah, let's go!
Alex, I'm down. What about you guys? Let us know if you'd take the trip and why using the hashtag YouTube Nation. And now to play us out, the man who fell to Earth, David Bowie.
Oh, man.